Greetings, children of the screen, your friendly neighborhood nerd scum here once again. And you know what, guys? I love B-movies, and I love Power Rangers, and I love gore, and I love tokusatsu, and I really loved Manborg, and I really loved The Void. So you know what? I think it's past time that I take a look at Psycho Goreman.
Many moons ago, a nameless evil was imprisoned in a place far beyond reach.
Hurry up!
If he were ever to be released, it would spell certain doom for all existence.
Psycho Goreman, released in 2021, unrated, with a runtime of 95 minutes. The film is written and directed by Stephen Kostansky, with a cast that includes Nina Josie Hanna, Owen Meyer, Matthew Ninibar, Stephen Blanos, Adam Brooks, Alexis Cara Hensi, Kristen McCulloch, and Anna Torini. Right on, guys. So, Psycho Goreman. So, the basic story of this is a couple of kids, Mimi and Luke, after having an epic game of crazy ball, dig a big hole that Luke is to be buried in because he lost the game, and in doing so, they find a gem that controls an ancient evil that wants to destroy the universe. So, of course, these two kids make friends with it, and teach it how to play games, and you know, basically Mimi's kind of a bully, so she gets it to do her like bidding, and you know, turn one of the boys she has a crush on into a big ugly brain creature. But the bigger problem is that now that this being is awake, there are other ancient powers from the universe that are aware of this, and they're not happy about it, so they're gonna come and kick his ass. Therefore, we get tons of awesome gore intense violence from guys in basically the equivalent of Power Ranger villain costumes that are done very, very well. That is your basic story. And of course, you know, you have the thing from the classic trope of the kids who, like, make a friend with, like, a big scary monster or animal or criminal or something like that. We've seen the basic archetype of this story done many times, and it follows all the same beats and tropes. This director in particular, like I said, I really, really enjoyed both Manborg and The Void, and in both of those, and in most of the films I've seen of his, he very much tries to affect kind of a 1980s, early 1990s pacing and structure and feel, and part of doing that is using these kind of very tropey, archetypal plot lines and character types and things of that nature. But he always finds a way to inject something, you know, fresh and original and uniquely him into it. It's always like a nice combination of different versions of those elements that create something that, while it's something you've seen before, it's still something new and fresh. The cast in this movie all turn in pretty solid performances. The kids in the movie are absolutely great. There's never a point in the movie where I had trouble watching them. Now, mind you, the little girl who plays Mimi is doing an excellent job, and she comes the closest to not being able to watch her, but that's not because of her performance. That's because she is performing a character that is so irritating and so much of a bully so well that it's sometimes you're just like, why are we following this kid? But in context of the way they do it, it makes kind of a certain kind of sense and is really funny. Because again, as I said, this director likes to play on tropes of, you know, the 80s and 90s. In a lot of 80s and 90s movies, when you have a kid who, like, some characters refer to as a bully, they're actually a homicidal maniac. You know, just look at things like Stand By Me, or a few other movies, especially Stephen King movies, where, like, It is a good example. The bullies are much more closer to just psychopathic killers, and the character of Mimi plays it very close to the line, where, like, she definitely has moments where she allows Psycho Goreman to do horrible things for her, and there are other times where she considers it and jokes a lot about it, but they keep it just on this side enough of it that we can still have fun with it to a certain extent. And also, the people doing the performance for Psycho Goreman is absolutely fantastic, both the voice and the in-suit performance. The parents of the kids are really fun, And overall, just like all the supporting kind of like monster creatures are performed really, really well. For the kind of movie this is, everything is exactly as it should be in terms of performances, and was very easy for me to just go along with it and enjoy the movie. And since I had mentioned it there, the makeup and special effects in this movie are pretty fantastic. Specifically, all the costumes and suits are really great. They're all very interesting and creative. And there are some of them that I really enjoy that are kind of done intentionally crappy, as would be in this kind of thing. I felt that there were, as much as these pulling influences from specific types of movies, I felt there was a very strong Power Ranger influence on this particular movie. And this especially shows with some of these other villainous characters. Specifically the Templar character, as well as kind of some of the people at this council of, you know, other ancient alien beings, where like there's like specifically there's a guy who just has like a big neck and a face and his mouth just kind of hangs. And it seems very much like a strong visual reference to Power Rangers. But yes, all the makeup and all the like practical effects in the movie are absolutely awesome, whether they're supposed to be cheesy or they're just supposed to be cool. They work pretty much all around. Psycho Goreman's design is a little, I don't want to say ordinary, but like it's nothing that really stands out, but it is very, very cool. And it's one of those things where he looks very typical, but at the same time, it still looks legitimately awesome. And it works really well for what they need to do in the movie, because he looks cool, but he doesn't have so much stuff on him that when it's time for the action sequences, he looks too ridiculous, like he can't perform through the suits. A lot of the digital effects in the movie are pretty crappy, but that's, I feel, intended, because again, it feels like it's trying to kind of mimic the effects from some of the cheaper kind of tokusatsu or even Power Rangers type things. That works for it as well. And then the miniature work they have, which isn't a whole lot of miniature work, but the miniature work that they do employ in the movie is absolutely fantastic and equally cheesy and awesome. So all around, the effects work really decently. As for the look of the film, I really enjoyed it overall. It is one of those weird things where, like, you know, in Manborg, there's much more of a sense of trying to make it look like a movie from the period that he's aping off of, and it doesn't really always work as well as you would like it to. Whereas in this movie, it's still very contemporary, and he's using a lot of the elements from those older kind of movies and stuff, but the visual style isn't dependent on it. And again, I think that's one of the things that gives me like a more modern Power Ranger feel to some of the scenes in it, is that like it's not, you know, overly expansive with dramatic lighting and all that kind of stuff. When they do that stuff, it looks really good, but there's a lot of scenes where it's just like kids out in the daytime with a monster. And you very much get, again, that strong like Power Ranger feel, but like in a good way. Like the cinematography is good, the compositions are good, like the lighting is good, but at the same time, for the majority of the movie, it's not the kind that's like, hey, look at me, I'm doing something special. It's just like, nope, here it is. Kids and a monster walking through the woods. That's what you get. And that works really well to the movie's advantage. It's, when I say it, it sounds like I'm saying it as a negative, but I am absolutely not. Like, it gives the movie a very unique feel and visual tone that allows it to then, when it does do something crazy and cool, for that to really be like an impressive moment, like a moment that has an effect on you. So the visuals of the film are absolutely awesome. So for the music in the film, they have Blitz Berlin, which is a Canadian trio doing the music. These people also did the music for The Void by this director, and music in that was really solid, and the music in this was fantastic. I really enjoyed all the music, and the way that it's put into the movie really, really works as well. And again, it's one of those weird things that when we're in the title sequence, especially of this movie, I got strong, like, old school, like, Lasserman Power Rangers theme song vibes off of that. Just like something about the guitar riffs that were going on definitely invoked that feel. Although that is not really indicative of the overall soundtrack, like it all has that kind of like electro rock for a lot of it, but not the Power Ranger feel. Like even in the beginning, as I said, when they're playing their crazy ball game, like you get this awesome epic rock and roll score that then all of a sudden cuts off and we pull back and you see, oh yeah, it's just like the sounds of two kids playing, and it's really, really fun. And then there's a lot of other kind of musical arrangements that are put in the movie that are far less noticeable, but really accentuate the scenes that they play in. So yeah, again, the music is another win for this movie. So yeah, guys, I wish I had checked this movie out earlier because I definitely was not disappointed. As you could hear, I don't really have any major complaints about the movie going through it. You know, from every tier, it feels like people put their best foot forward and we got a solid product. Now, for some people who are not as versed in the tropes or the older movies that this is kind of referencing and playing off of in terms of pacing, tropes, tone, characters, all those kind of things, there might be elements that don't work for you as well as they do for me, but because this thing is clearly so inspired by so many different things that I love, and it's coming from a creator that knows how to take those things and replicate the way they feel, but improve upon the actual product that is, you know, surrounding all those tropes, I really, really enjoyed it. I can't recommend it highly enough. If you love all those things that I mentioned at the beginning of the video, or if you like this director's previous work, this definitely will not disappoint. Basically, it is just funny, mean kids and monsters in, like, bad Power Ranger costumes. I say bad Power Ranger villain costumes, but they're not bad. They look awesome, but that's the feel you get off of it, and just with, like, the most graphically gory violence that you can imagine. So yeah, if that sounds awesome to you, and you haven't checked this movie out, definitely do it. You will not be disappointed. Thank you very much for watching, guys. I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please leave a like and share it with some friends. Also, if you're not subscribed, make sure to subscribe so you can check out all the dope content I'll have coming out in the future. Right on, children of the screen. Once again, thank you very much. Hope you have a good one. Nerd scum.